when I'm looking at Chemi's chart, I see that her day master, which is representative of you, of the self, is a yang fire. So that tells me that she's warm-hearted, she's kind, compassionate, generous, open-minded. I see that she has a lot of resources and intelligence in her chart. So she probably presents as being conservative, polite, disciplined. When I'm looking at her relationships, I can see that she has a close relationship with her mother, like very friendly relationship. Her father may have been a little maybe dominating in terms of what he may have wanted her to study or maybe career-wise. And sometimes he may have had to speak, maybe not directly to her, but maybe through the mother to share with her. It shows that she's very supportive of her children and her spouse. Within her chart, she has a clash, which may indicate that maybe there may have been maybe either a family conflict early on, or it can indicate that she herself, because the bottom where we might see conflict is our foundation. So at times she may have felt very unsure, especially when she was younger. Maybe she may have felt a little doubt, insecurities, really hard on herself and really questioning herself a lot. She has a lot of earth elements, which is her intelligence. So she's smart and has skills and many talents. She actually also has a money element in her chart. And this money element tells me that she's actually capable to handle other people's money, possibly even be in finances, money matters. And because for Chemi, money is a favorable element. Money, metal is her money element in her chart. And so she does have that. And earth and metal are her most favorable elements. But if you look at her metal element in her year pillar up there, that's really the only metal she has in her BaZi. And metal is a very favorable element, supposed to be a favorable element to Chemi, but it's surrounded by water. So if you remember, if metal has to give off too much water, it gets exhausted, right? And so my recommendation for Chemi would be take care of her metal element. And like we had said, metal element relates to breathing organs. And for me in this chart, when I look at it, it's telling me that she might have issues with her teeth and she may be prone to having sore throats when I look at it. She also has some very special inborn stars. And when we look at someone's chart, you know, there's a lot of stars that may come in to help enhance like some things for you. So for Chemi, I see that she has the star of art, which gives her added talents and creativity skills. And especially, it actually shows up later too. And so it also looks like maybe later she'll be using a lot more creativity and a lot of her skills to maybe teach more or something in the spiritual aspects. And she also has the Heaven Star of Virtue. And that's a very powerful star. And it can only be inborn in your chart. So you can only be born with that. But it brings many powerful mentors, helpful people. So whenever she's in need of support, there's always someone that can come in and assist her. She also has the dragon. And the dragon is the sign of intuition. And so she was actually born with intuition.
Even when I read my own reading, it was quite interesting, especially in the part where my health with my lungs and teeth and sore throat, you know, for that health issue, because I have had pretty much all my life, that's kind of where I've had those issues. And there were surprises as well, because there have been aspects in my life where I would have doubted that I had more of that inborn nature to have like the finances and things like that, because those are the areas that I actually kind of like did not want to really deal with. So it's good to know, because then it empowers me to understand that I do have the potential that I can work on that. And as Catherine was going over all of the, you know, examples of the year, it was funny because I really do. And I was telling myself, I really do need to reorganize and kind of just help myself restructure and prioritize certain things in my life. And as she was saying, you know, I've been very blessed to have powerful mentors and supporters like Master Pam and my mom and, you know, all of you that has helped to guide me along the way, because really I wouldn't be here if I didn't have, of course, truly in my heart, I know if I didn't have Master Shah and didn't have my dad to actually guide us to Master Shah at the time. So it was interesting because, you know, how you said my dad kind of was the one that kind of wanted me to be certain thing, and really he wanted me to be a teacher, but more in the traditional teacher sense. You know, after college, he got me a job at the high school, but then I realized, oh, I don't want to be like a teacher in high school. So I went back to school and became an OT. And it was almost where I almost wanted to like go the opposite of what he wanted me to do. And yet OT, occupational therapists, we're teaching somebody every day. In fact, I had my teacher as a patient yesterday, and it was the funniest thing. She goes, oh, it's so funny now the roles are reversed. I have to listen to you because you're teaching me. And it's just a great awareness and an understanding for my own life and my own path. And I'm grateful for, you know, now knowing like the choices I've made, because even becoming an occupational therapist, at first I was going to be a physical therapist, but I didn't know that occupational therapy existed. And it just so happened they had no volunteer spots for being a physical therapist at Rehab of the Pacific. So they stuck me in the OT section because nobody knew what that was. But I really am more of an OT than a PT. But heaven has always been so, you know, I've been so grateful that heaven has blessed me with those opportunities to just kind of follow and get into that area. So this BaZi reading really confirms and helps me to understand even more so how I can make those positive changes and transformations in my life, as well as integrating all of the wisdom that and the blessings that we learned from Master Shah. So this is like a perfect, beautiful like marriage of the two, like complements each other. So thank you so much for this opportunity to share.
Thank you for watching that video of Chiemi getting her BaZi reading from Catherine. And if you notice, one of the areas that she wanted to transform were the messages of self-doubt. So this is a practice I may recommend to her to help her develop greater confidence, releasing those negative messages of self-doubt and self-questioning. And you can join along with me to also benefit from this practice. So let's get started. So first of all, close your eyes and take a nice natural breath inhale. And see if you can bring that light and that breath all the way down to your lower abdomen. Exhale, and let that light expand throughout your body. And notice if you can find where you may be holding these messages of self-doubt that you might have, these messages of lack of confidence within yourself. And just notice the color, the shape, the size, without judgment of these sensations or these messages. I'm just wanting you to connect to where in your body you are holding these messages. And if you are unable to locate them, just allow yourself to breathe in through the bottom of your torso, which is the root chakra, which is known to be a powerful energy foundation center to help us to develop greater confidence, as well as many other wonderful things, such as enhancing relationships. So inhale light through that area. Exhale. We're going to imagine that the light is expanding in our body, and we're going to clear out these negative messages of self-doubt, bringing in the message of confidence. And we're going to be using a tool to help us, which is this Tao calligraphy card. This is Da Guang Ming, greatest light. So I want you to inhale this message of greatest light, the greatest light of confidence from this transformative healing art of Tao calligraphy. So inhale, feel this card, please help to develop confidence. Inhale this light to the area that you're feeling the blockage or your root chakra. Exhale, let that light of confidence expand as your negative messages are being released, cleared out, cleansed from that area that you're holding these negative messages. Again, inhale light, light and love of confidence into the area of your body or your first chakra. Exhale. Light rotates gently and expands in that area, releasing the negative messages, expanding the light of confidence. One more time, inhale. This light of confidence into our being. Exhale. Breathe out. Blockages are released. The light and message of confidence expanding and radiating within your being. And we end this practice with thank you, thank you, thank you. This is just a short few minutes practice, but you can do much more. And you can learn much more about these sacred tools we have, sacred practices and wisdom that can help you change any negative messages that you find no longer serves you in your life, that may come from your BaZi reading, or just these are messages that you know you carry. So I welcome you to come February 19th at 1 to 5 p.m. Hawai'i time. Please join. We are honored to serve you. Aloha.